What do you mind talking to us about it? And that's what I did. So I didn't run to nobody. And so that was real misleading to me.
Well, I didn't say you ran to anybody. I said that you had taken a pivot.
Well, you said I ran over to the Trump team instead of the Biden team. That's just not true.
Well, but you are working with the Trump team instead of the Biden team, and people are giving you heat for it. What do you say to them?
Well, I'm willing to work with both teams, but I'm just working with whoever is willing to work with me. So the Trump campaign came to me and asked me to explain to them some of the contract with Black America. That's what I did. I'm not playing no more of these games, these political games. We're not part of a team. We have very broad problems, especially the wealth gap in this country when it comes to Black Americans. So I'm going to whoever's in power, and I'm going to speak to them about our problems specifically. I'm not going there talking about minorities. I'm not going there talking about people of color or diversity or none of that stuff. I'm going there for Black Americans, the ones who are the descendants of slaves. And that's what I'm going to talk to anybody who's in power with that. So if anybody got a problem with that, it seems like a personal problem.
Well, here's the problem, and it is very personal, as you know, for a lot of people of color, because they'll say, well, why would you pick Trump when he says there's no such thing as systemic inequality?
Say again? I'm not picking nobody. He's the president.
But why do you think he'd want to do something for the community when he says there's no such thing as systemic inequality?
I don't know what he want to do. I just know what the man said. I know what he said to the country. I've never met Donald Trump. So I don't know what he's going to do. I just know what he said he was going to do. So both of them have a plan. Both of them say they're going to do something. And who knows what's really going to happen after November 3rd. Nobody knows from each side. We're all hoping that candidates keep their campaign promises. So that's just it.
So let's look at it this way. I think that you're right to be skeptical. Let's start with the Democrats, because even though there is a traditional connection between Black voters and the Democrats, you could also say you've been let down or forgotten by Democrats in a lot of situations that would have mattered. Then you say, all right, so then what makes one side better than the other? That's where you get in trouble, which is, do you really think that Donald Trump can be trusted as much as you could trust Joe Biden?
I don't think I'm not trusting any of them. I'm just going by action. That's all I'm going by. I'm not going by words, not going by rhetoric, not going by media spin, not going by none of that. You know, I'm not on nobody's team. I'm not on Team Blue, not on Team Red.
So then I have that wrong.
I'm an independent person, and I believe that's what Black people need to do, is become independent, and we need to get something for our vote. You know, that may not happen, but it's going to happen.
It's got to happen. Nothing changes if nothing changes. Look, if I had brought you here to fight with you, you would have known it. What I'm saying is, I think I did get it wrong, and I want to make sure I get it right. So saying you're working with the Trump team is wrong. What you did was, when they asked to talk to you about it, you said yes. If Biden had asked to talk to you about it now, you would have gone to them the same way. It's not about you choosing anything. It's you working with everybody who's got a chance of doing anything.
Working with whoever's in power. Yeah, I'll work with both. Whoever's in power, I'm going to work with. So whoever wins, they'll hear from me.
Okay. So I'm glad you came to clear it up. So Ice Cube is not with the Trump campaign. He's just given his idea.